The best heavy tank produced by Germany in World War II came a little too late and too few of them to make much difference, and of course the Allies having complete air domination at the time rendered these things very ineffective. However, if they did come up against a one-on-one with any of the other tanks, these things rocked. Of course, you do see the original Tiger tank in the film The Fury, and it's the only remaining Tiger tank that is still in any functional operation today. Here we see the Sherman tank. Over 50,000 of these were produced over the course of the war, used by America and her allies. A medium tank, they were the backbone of the American armor. There are 30 Sherman tanks here today. I know what you were thinking. You were thinking, no fair. The Shermans had to drive and the King Tigers didn't. So guess what? We switch things round. This time it's the Tigers. The Shermans are staying put. Wow, look at all those rounds raining in. Looks like you might be onto something if you were saying that. So far, Tigers a little bit stunned. That's an awful lot of fire raining in. Tigers eating multiples to the face, as of yet unsure if they've managed to hinder anyone. That is a lot of rounds coming in. Things looking very different this time. And that looks like they might have gotten their first kill. All three Tigers going, and at least I'd say four or five Shermans look like they have met their end. Tigers definitely eating more of these to the face now that they're having to move. I mean, look at that. That middle one there just ate about six, seven rounds in the time it took me to eat that. Say that sentence. There was at least three or four more. Wow. Surely that guy doesn't have long left. Look how many he's eating to the face. That crew's got to be having a headache in the morning, right? Even if they don't die. I mean, how loud is it being hit by a shell in a tank? Imagine. Looks like the first row of Shermans in smoke. Totaling about 10, I'd say there's still about two-thirds of them left. The Tigers edging forward, not deterred by the amount of fire that they're eating, which is bizarre. We saw the Shermans were a lot more careful in their approach, especially when one of their teammates died. They all seemed to pause for a bit. Seems the Tigers aren't actually bothered about that whatsoever. Seems their ideas to keep moving. Would have thought they might stay a bit further away and exploit the advantages their huge rounds would give them, but apparently not. Tiger, of course, using the 88mm shell. Very much an all-rounder used in the German military during the war. Artillery and triple A, extremely effective. Of course, the AKAC being used against air and tanks, favoured by the infantry units, especially once they lost faith in the Luftwaffe, which basically never got it back together again after the Battle of Britain. All three tanks remain. I like the spacing between them. That forces the enemy, you know, has to pick on a target. It can't quickly switch between one and the other. As and when it becomes suitable, it's like the distance between them forces them to pick one. Don't know if the AI is deliberately keeping that distance because of that reason or something else, but I thought that was a Tiger dead then, but it's not. It was just its massive cannon firing. This central one Looks like it was smoking a little bit there. The one on the right creating a huge fuss when it fires. Still all eating multiple shots. Some really big explosions now coming from the tigers when they shoot. I'm not sure if that's... Are they using a different type of animation? Or are they starting to get damage? I don't know. Or is it the Shermans firing high explosives in? Incredible. They're gonna manage it, aren't they? Three out of three Tigers still remain, and the Shermans are smoking everywhere. There's at least three or four Shermans remaining. You've got to think at this point the tank commanders and the crew have got to be requiring a change of underwear and possibly, I don't know, I'd probably be thinking of bailing and running away. Two guys remain. One gets another shot off at the central Tiger, who has none of it, fires one back. It's like one Sherman remaining. That has got to be the thumbnail. Wow. What I didn't expect was, when checking the F10 map afterwards, those three King Tigers were in perfect condition. So whether that's entirely accurate, I'm not so sure. Who knows? I wasn't there. I've read some fantastic stories of guys going Rambo in this with their crew and racking up insane numbers of kills, especially on the Eastern Front, where the Russians didn't maintain 24/7 air dominance, especially at night. Perhaps another story for another day. So until then, wherever in the world you may be, take care. Bye-bye.